Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another top five, sort of. Now, this is a top five for Mega Evolutions as it would be in Pokemon Sun and Moon. Because, it's not really a top 10 since there are lots of ties. So, this is basically a top 13 because there are 13 Pokemon. Okay, let's just get started with the honorable mention. One honorable mention is Excadrill. Now, with Excadrill, I think you should make the attack boost attack higher. And HP higher. Maybe the speed, I'm not really sure. You could keep that one. But you should really keep the defenses the same. And because it does have a lot of resistances. Another one is Fearow. The only reason Fearow would have been on the list is because Pidgeot got one. I like Fearow more. Another one is Golem. Now, Golem, you could replace the ground typing with fire if it's like magma. If you like have fire around the like, you know, the like. Like lines, but Almighty Mandel's just discussed how Golem could be like in his top 10 Pokemon, in his top 10 Pokemon that could be he, that could be Mega Evolutions in Pokemon Sun and Moon. My last honorable mention is Blissey, because in my top 10 favorite Pokemon, I actually discussed that this should have a Mega Evolution. And I said in my top 10 favorite Pokemon video that, well, you could just watch that in the description below. The Almighty Mandel's video will also be in the description below. Now onto the list. Number 5 is Butterfree. Now, I think with Butterfree you could take away the flying type with the psychic type. Oh, and you gave Beedrill one, but not Butterfree. It just makes no sense. I think you could do with Butterfree is make the special attack like higher, like Alakazam high, that kind of high, and that's base, and make its HP a little higher so you could make it take some hits. Number 4 is a tie between Slowking and Froslass now. What? They're on the list because they're a part of branched evolution. Slowking is a part is with Slowbro and Froslass is with Glalie. Now, the other part of the branched evolution being Slowbro and Glalie, they got Mega Evolution. So I think it's fair enough that Slowking and Froslass get Mega Evolutions. Some changes I could make to this is that with Slowbro you made it physically defenses. Now it's Slowking. I think you could make it special defensive. And that's my only thing I could come up with. Slowking. Now with Froslass, I think you could keep the speed where it is. That's high enough. For everything else, I think you should boost them a little more, because it still needs to deal some damage and get some too. Which means take some damage. Number 3 is Magmortar and Electivire. With Magmortar, I think you should boost up the special attack up to like 100 and somewhere in the high hundreds. And with Electivire, you should boost the attack. Now I think both could really take get can both get some speed and physical defense up because those seem pretty low. Not much of Electivire, but really a lot for Magmortar. Number 2 is a tie between the Johto starters and the Hoenn starters. I'm gonna start with the Johto starters because they were out longer. Now, I think the Johto starters will work the same with the Kanto starters. Like, X and Y was sort of like Pokemon Red and Blue. Now, I think Pokemon Sun and Moon would be like Pokemon Gold and Silver. So, I think the three of these Pokemon should get Mega Evolutions. With Meganium, I think you can up the attack and defense more. You can keep the speed and HP. That's okay. It's pretty okay from Meganium. With Typhlosion, should make the special attack go higher and make it more defensive so it can take some hits. with for alligator, really boost the attack and defense, but just moderately with the other ones. Okay, now for okay, I think with the universe starters, why they should get Mega Evolutions is that they already had at a pre they already had their games and a sequel. So I think at some point you should just give them Mega Evolutions. Now with Superior, boost the speed and give it some more attack so it could deal some damage. With Emboar, I think most things are pretty much okay, but just for the defense, because, well, it's pretty much fighting type, so I think you should give the defense, give it more defense and speed. I know it's like over 300 pounds, really. Martial artists are, I don't know, I think they could take a few hits and be fast. Now, Samurott. Most of its moveset is physical, but its special attack is higher. So I think its regular attack should be higher than special attack when it mega evolves. Also, make the speed higher because samurais are pretty fast. And number one is. So before we unveil number one, I just have to say, every single region in that had Mega Evolutions had two pseudo legendaries that could Mega Evolve. Number one is the two pseudo legendaries that I think will evolve in Pokemon Sun and Moon, which are Hydreigon and Dragonite. Dragonite, I think should get a Mega Evolution is because it's the oldest pseudo legendary. Why doesn't it have a Mega Evolution yet? I think it should have had a Mega Evolution more than Garchomp since it didn't really need Mega Evolution. With Dragonite, I think you could boost the defense and up the attacks, okay, but the special attack, I think you could work more with the special attacks. Because there he knows just as much special attack moves as physical attack. Now Hydreigon, I think should have a like mega is because then this would be the only pseudo legendary the youngest the oldest I guess that would have a mega evolution if a Dragonite ever got a mega evolution. Now what I could do to improve Hydreigon is its defense and special and with and its end attack because most of its moveset is attack. So same thing for Samurott, make its attack higher than its special attack and boost some of the defenses because I'm not really living with my Hydreigon. So that was my list. But yours are clearly better. So tell me your list in the comments below and smash that like button in the face. Make sure to hit that red subscribe button. And don't and don't be shadowed, my little Gengars.